Welcome to Thoroughbred Action at Gulfstream Park. I'm Katie Stazak. It's Sunday, and we're getting ready to cap what's been another fantastic week of racing here at Gulfstream. We've got 10 races on tap, and we have carryovers in both the Rainbow Six, which begins in race number 5, and the Super High Five, which will be the final race of the day in race 10. Let's get things started. Here are the track and weather conditions.
The main track is fast and the turf course is firm. The Sunday opener is a $12,500 maiden claimer. Three-year-olds and up will be sprinting 5 furlongs on the turf course. Scratch the 2, Traficante. Also, Jonathan Gonzalez will be aboard the 10, Abran Paso.
Racing at Gulfstream. From the center, that's Gunnery, who gets the first call. From Radamel, who comes away racing in second. Up on the outside, it's Abran Paso, who sets up shop third. Executive Mandate down to the inside is now fourth. From between horses, that's Dream of Derby. 3 wide out there is Super Secret. He might be stacked 4 deep by the time they hit the turn. 2 lengths better than Forest Warrior, then Rapid Lightning. As they run around the far turn, Massive John is far back. On top, Gunnery shakes free for Boulanger, stretches the speed to 2.5 in front. Racing second is Radamel. From third, it's Abran Paso. Everyone will have to pick up their feet to beat Gunnery. He's striding away now by 3.5 lengths. Under the whip ride from second is Abran Paso. Back third inside is Radamel, and Executive Mandate is next, and Gunnery spins him in. Abran Paso and Gonzalez start to get to him now. Here's Abran Paso on the outside. Gunnery toward the inside, nip and tuck. 5 back to the outside, and third is Forest Warrior, but Abran Paso colors the leader and moves away. Abran Paso, the winner. Gunnery second. Third, Forest Warrior in front of Super Secret fourth and 57-3.
Abran Paso gamely runs down Gunnery to take the first race. Jonathan Gonzalez picks up the mount today and gets the win for trainer Oscar Gonzalez and owners Robin Team Show, LLC. Abran Paso returned $5.20 for the victory. The second race is a $10,000 maiden claimer. Fillies and mares 3 year olds and up will be going 7 furlongs on the main track. No scratches or jockey changes to report.
And they're off. Toward the inside, Valid Wildfire is showing speed today, but Transcendent Faith is quicker in the early stages. Lalolai comes away on the outside. She's now second. See Charlie Run is third, so Valid Wildfire will settle in fourth in front of Mischievous Charlie. Spiritual Leader wrangled back off the speed, 2 better than Coquitona, and the early trailer is Desert Turf. Down the back stretch, led by Lalolai, who leads at 1/2 length. Transcendent Faith is second. Stretch of 3 to see Charlie Ron, well-placed, well third. In front of an improving Mischievous Charlie, she's 3 wide, but moving up to be a joint 4th. Then to the inside, Valid Wildfire is now 5th, 2 better than an improving Coquitona with Spiritual Leader and Desert Turf. Opening quarter, Casual Enough, 23-3. Around the far turn they go. With the lead, it's Transcendent Faith toward the outside. That's Lalolai. 2.5 better than Mischievous Charlie, who's now racing in third. Valid Wildfire continues to chip away while fourth. She's actually going to split horses here. So Miguel Vasquez and Valid Wildfire now take the lead. Mischievous Charlie on the outside, and here's Desert Turf. She was last early. She just cut the corner and moves away now. Desert Turf is 25-1 and in front. Valid Wildfire comes right back at her on the outside. Now Valid Wildfire is back in front. Desert Turf is second. Mischievous Charlie is third. Back fourth is Transcendent Faith, but in deep stretch, it will be Valid Wildfire. Valid Wildfire and Miguel Vasquez will win it here by 4 or 5 lengths. Mischievous Charlie was second. It's close for third, either Desert Turf or Transcendent Faith.
After finishing second in 3 straight starts, Valid Wildfire gets a breakthrough victory in the second race. She is much the best here and scores by 6.5 lengths. Under Miguel Vasquez. Marcelo Cuito was the winning trainer for owners Marcelo Cuito Racing Stables, LLC.
Point of entry would not be denied. And they're into the stretch.
Point of entry's taking the lead.
Point of entry, a 2-length lead.
It's point of entry taking the lead.
Point of entry will go to the Breeders'
on
Cup.
On a 5-race winning streak.
5-time Grade 1 winner from a deep Phipps family. With the pedigree and physical to become the heir of Dynaformer, Point of Entry. Standing at Adena Springs.
Race 3 is a $6,250 claiming event. Fillies and mares 3 year olds and up, which have not won 3 races or which have not won a race since January 12th, will be sprinting 6 furlongs on the main track.
They're off. From the center, Ya Astah gets the first call. Phoebe Moon broke running down to the inside. Here's Distinctly Sweet being centaured as they run down the backstretch, emerging between horses. Something Blue and Airs the Storm. So it will be Something Blue who takes the lead from Airs the Storm, now second. From Ya Astah, who won the start, she's third. BB Valentine to the outside, followed wide by Phoebe Moon. Then Rita Davina between them. Party Till Dawn is second last, and Distinctly Sweet, after being sent out of the gate, is last of all as they run around the far turn. They're chasing the speed of Something Blue, who leads it by two lengths now. Distinctly Sweet is still last, and now we're moving into second now as There's the Storm. Ya Astah looks loaded, needs room down inside, moving third at the 5/16th, in front of BB Valentine, then Phoebe Moon and Senorita Davina, and they run to the top of the stretch. There's a quarter of a mile left to go. Ya Astah works off the fence to try to get Something Blue. There's the Storm drifted wide, carrying out Phoebe Moon. Senorita Davina cuts the corner into the stretch. Ya Astah now to the front. Back to second is Something Blue. Senorita Davina coming up the inside, Phoebe Moon on the outside. But inside the final furlong, it's Ya Astah moving clear. Ya Astah and Harry Hernandez moving off to win it in the end by 3 or 4. Second, Something Blue in front of Senorita Davina, then Phoebe Moon and Party Till Dawn at 111 and 3.
Ya Astah returns from a 4-month layoff to score a 2.5-length win in the third race. Harry Hernandez was the winning jockey for owner and trainer Rohan Creighton. Ya Astah paid $9.20 to win. On to the fourth race now, an $8,000 claimer. Fillies and Mares 3-year-olds and up, which have not won 3 races or which have not won a race since January 12th, will be going 7.5 furlongs on the turf course.
They're up. Poor beginning for Mambo Maya. Quick beginning for Sylvie Kova from the outside gate. Moving in the center, here's Run Gia Run. And Run Gia Run will do just that. She'll take the lead and drop over to the inside in the run to the first turn. Sylvie Kova dropped over to be second now toward the inside. That's The Business who's moving up. The Business is third. Feeling Better Today is on the inside. Wide on the course is Darn Proud. And from between horses and the racing about 5 or 6 behind is Giselle Mabel. Stretch of another 2.5 lengths to the gray Gigi's Miracle with Dakota Eyes to the inside. And the early trailers, the poor starter Mambo Maya. Winging up top, Run Gia Run. She's running. She's on top by 8 after a 23-3 opening quarter. Run Gia Run and John Cruz on a mission. They've throttled the open now to lead it by 10. Racing up on the inside, it's Feeling Better Today of The Business, who's still racing second now. Racing fourth is Sylvie Kova, then Darn Proud and Giselle Mabel. 2 lengths better than an improving Dakota Ides, Georgetown style to the inside. Gigi's Miracle second last. The trailer is Mambo Maya, and Run Gia Run still has the lead, but the strides are shortening a bit. Her lead is down to 6 lengths. The Business getting after a second. Feeling Better Today will try to slipstream from there. From the outside in Sylvie Kova, then Giselle Mabel. They run to the top of the stretch. Run Gia Run. She's run every step. And she's still 5 in front. The Business is now starting to get after a second. Sylvie Kova is next, then Feeling Better Today, and Giselle Mabel, top of the lane. Here's The Business, and Edgar Prado to take on Run Gia Run. Down the center, and Giselle Mabel. The Business takes the lead. Giselle Mabel down the center, coming on. Giselle Mabel has momentum. Giselle Mabel in front and moving clear. The Business back to second, then Run Gia Run and Darn Proud at 131 flat.
The Business runs down Run Gia Run, and then Giselle Mabel runs down The Business. Giselle Mabel gets the victory under Eddie Dominguez. The winning trainer is Max Ubide, and the winning owner, Carol Kemp. Giselle Mabel paid $34.20 to win. On to the fifth race now, a $6,250 claiming event. 3-year-olds and up will be going 1 1/16 on the main track.
They're up. From the outside, Commander Tate gets the first call from the far outside gate. Here's Tis Time Is Now. Down to the inside, it's Bluegrass Jam moving up. So Bluegrass Jam and Tis Time Is Now. They'll get acquainted. They've opened a 2-length margin on Commander Tate, who races in third. Down to the inside, that's Keystone Cop, who's in early fourth. 2 better than Sir Sparky. Then it's a stretch of 4 to the inside, Super Doc, who's in front of the gray Saravastar. And Burning Time, as last of all, spots the leaders about 11 lengths in the run to the back stretch. Bluegrass Jam on the inside, Tis Time Is Now on the outside. They're in lockstep, 2 lengths better than Commander Tate, who loves life, taking it all in while third after the opening quarter went in 25 seconds flat. Keystone Cop follows along in fourth from Sir Sparky in fifth. These top flight horses have 6 or 7 lengths on the trailers, which are led by Super Doc, then Burning Time, and Saravastar last of all. They go down the backstretch, and nothing's changed on the top end. Tis Time is now alternating with the lead with Bluegrass Jam, two better than Commander Tate. Racing fourth is Keystone Cop. He's a bit closer now, and he's in the clear for Gaffleon. He's moving up within 2.5 of the lead after a 49.25 mile. Racing in fifth is Sir Sparky, trying to run on from the back. It's Burning Time. He swung into action with 8 lengths to make up and less than 3 furlongs to do it. Bluegrass Jam now puts away Tis Time is now. From the back, Sir Sparky's off cover. He was fifth. He's now third, now second, and making a challenge toward the lead. Burning Time running on from the back, and there's less than 1/4 mile to go. They turn for home with the short stretch run. Here's Sir Sparky to take on Bluegrass Jam. Commander Tate looks for room for Gonzalez. He'll tip him into the 2-path, and there's less than 3/16 to go. Bluegrass Jam trying to come back. It's Sir Sparky who just took the lead. Commander Tate is third. And deep stretch, Sir Sparky waiting around a bit now. Here's Bluegrass Jam coming back on the inside to the finish. Sir Sparky wins. Sir Sparky gets the money toward the inside. That was Bluegrass Jam second and Commander Tate third.
Sir Sparky makes a bold move around the turn and comes away with the victory in race 5. Luca Panici was the winning jockey for trainer Alfred McIntosh and owner Lucille Garanis. Sir Sparky paid $30.80 to win.
There's a new day dawning in Florida. Never before has a Breeders' Cup Classic winner retired to stud in the Sunshine State. Until now. Adina Springs presents 3-time Grade 1 winner and earner of over $4 million. Fort Larned. New to Adina Springs South.
The 6th race is a maiden special weight. 2-year-olds will be sprinting 5 furlongs on the turf course. Scratch the 11 and the 13.
And they're off. From the center, that's Applicator who gets the first call. Moving up on the outside is Chesson and My Kind of Cat from down toward the inside. My Kind of Cat's ahead in front. Applicator is second, Chesson is third. These top three have sped away from Mr. Cotto, who's a joint fourth. Inside is Cajun Shell. He's 2 lengths better than an inside running Mike. Then from the outside is Proud Enough and Warrior AP. It's a stretch of another 5 lengths back. Second last is 220. And even farther back, the trailer here is Stanowski. They run to the top of the stretch. Down to the inside is My Kind of Cat by a head. Applicator is still second. Here's Cajun Shell tipping off the fence to rally home. Chesson is now fourth from Mr. Cotto and Warrior AP, and they're at the top of the stretch. Here's Cajun Shell on the outside. Let loose and opening up now. Back to second is My Kind of Cat. Late run down the center from Warrior AP and Mr. Cotto. But in deep stretch, Cajun Shell bids this field a pleasant Sunday. Good afternoon. Cajun Shell wrapped up in the end to win it under Eddie Castro by 4 or 5. It's a 3-way go for second. Maybe Chesson over Mr. Cotto and Warrior AP in 57-4.
Cajun Shell absolutely relishes the grass in the 6th race. He draws off impressively in his turf debut for trainer Bill Kaplan. Eddie Castro was the winning jockey for owners Teresa and David Palmer. Cajun Shell paid $5.60 to win. Let's get to the 7th race now. This is another maiden special weight for 2-year-olds. This time they'll be sprinting 5 furlongs on the main track. Scratch the 1 and the 14, that means the 13 formal summation will get in.
And they're off. From the center, Hard Nut to Crack begins nicely. Night Rhythm is showing speed, and up on the outside, here's Formal Summation. Formal Summation from the 13 post has the lead 3 parts of a length. Racing second is Night Rhythm while on hold. Abercorn is next. Hard Nut to Crack between horses. Out wide on the course is Mr. Ellie. Then it's 1.5 lengths back to the team of JR's Holiday, Jashnell, and El Sicion on the outside. It's a stretch of another 2 to Great Smoke, who's 4 lengths better than Holy Treasure. Second last is Toro de Oro, and it's far back in the early stages to Determinator. They're under the top of the stretch, and up top, it's Formal Summation. And Luis Castillo, after a 22-4 opening quarter time, he's 70-1, and he's 5 on top. Trying to track him down from second is Night Rhythm. Down the outside, late run coming from Mr. Ellie toward the inside, JR's Holiday. Inside the final furlong, Luis Castillo imploring on Formal Summation for more, but he's still well clear. Here's a 70-1 shocker. Here's Formal Summation. Easily. Mr. Ellie was second, Night Rhythm third, Evercorn and JR's Holiday in 58-3.
Formal Summation draws in and pulls a 70-1 upset in the 7th race. Luis Castillo was aboard for trainer Ernan Parra and owner Lynn Martin Boot. Formal Summation returned $152.60 to win. The eighth race is an allowance with an optional claiming tag of $16,000. Fillies and mares 3-year-olds and up will be going a mile on the turf course. No scratches, but one jockey change. Manuel Aguilar will be aboard the 10. She drives me wild.
They're off. From the center, Cracking Good Pens gets the first call. Standard Deal moves up on her outside, and Simplistic from down toward the inside. So it will be Arnie Fontanez and Simplistic to set the pace from Standard Deal in second. Cracking Good Pens is next. Bumped around a bit and a little tight is Odachi. She's in the top flight, though. She's now third and a length and a half off the lead. From the far outside, it's Jazzo's Dream. On heels a bit is Sweet Morgan. Toward the inside, Pentathlon saves ground. They're really tightly knit here. Image of Rachel had to shuffle to trail as moving by her on the outside, and now moving closer is Miss Motivation. Alongside, She Drives Me Wild. Separated by only 5 lengths in the run down the backstretch, and Simplistic has them stacked and packed and leads it a half a length after a 24-3 opening quarter. Standard Deal is there second. Wide on the outside, Miss Motivation, forcing the hand of Jazzo's Dream, who will have to quicken to keep her spot. Then it's Cracking Good Pens toward the inside. Odachi, she settled down to race about 4 lengths behind. Image of Rachel is next alongside Sweet Morgan. Between horses is Pentathlon, and now on the outside, She Drives Me Wild is last of all, and they went 48-2 for a half mile, and they run around the far turn. Three wide, Jazzle's Dream. Simplistic is next, and Standard Deal between horses. Cracking Good Pens trying to come from off the speed from fourth. Back fifth is Odachi, then to the inside, Image of Rachel, and they run to the top of the stretch. Jazzle's Dream confidently handled on the outside and up for a short lead after 3/4 in 1:12 flat. Standard Deal cuts the corner, tries to fight back second. Cracking Good Pens down the outside. Late run from Odachi. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Standard Deal's game up top. Cracking Good Pens come to down the center, and Jazzle's Dream surges between them. Jazzle's Dream now in front. Cracking Good Pens, a late say. Here's Cracking Good Pens in a photo with Jazzle's Dream. Too close to call and 1:37 flat.
Cracking Good Pens just gets up over Jazzle's Dream to take the eighth race. Edgard Zayas was the winning jockey for trainer Ron Spatz and owners Carson Springs Farm. Cracking Good Pens paid $19.80 to win. Welcome back. Let's get to the final two races of the day. The ninth is a $10,000 maiden claimer. 3-year-olds and up will be going a mile on the main track. A field of 12 will go to the post.
And they're off. Poor beginning for West Ride. Veering sharply at the beginning was Power. Starship Menace is on eventful away. He's from the outside trying to reach out for the early lead. Moving up in the center now, it's Criolla's Boy with Phil's Comprise coming away in the top flight. He's now off the speed as they run out of the 1 mile chute. So it's Starship Menace engaged by Roy Ayer, who pokes through to take the lead. Honey Up is showing speed, so is Criolla's Boy. And at the rail, that's 4Z, so they're 5 horses across the track. Length and a half back to Amphitatron, who's racing in 6, but he's only 2 behind. Then it's Phil's Comprise and Power. They're 4 lengths better than Far From Normal, with West Ride on the outside of him. It's another 2.5 lengths back to The Joke Is On Me, and Gavel Down is last of all as they rush down the backstretch. The opening quarter went in 24-1. It's a contested pace with a half a mile to go. Criolla's Boy leads it by a neck after a 47-4 half mile. Starship Menace is 4 wide. Huddy Up from between them. That's all for Roy Ayer. 4Z's with an inside lane. Ridden hard from the back and trying to gain ground is Amphitatron with Power. And they run to the top of the stretch. It's Criolla's Boy still held together up top. Huddy Up at 16-1 between horses second. Starship Menace begins to feel the strain. He's not finding from third. Amphitatron and 4Z's are next. Nobody running on from the back. So this is Criolla's Boy's race to win or lose. Criolla's Boy and Jonathan Gonzalez giving a crack of the crop and moving away by 2. 3/4 and 1:13 flat, and Criolla's Boy is in the clear. Back to second is Huddy Up, then 4Z's down the center, and Amphitatron, Starship Menace, and all the rest. They're left in the gray wake of Criolla's Boy. Criolla's Boy wrapped up and 5 in front. Huddy Up second, 4Z's third, Starship Menace fourth.
Criolla's Boy gives Jonathan Gonzalez his second victory of the day in race 9. Louis Duco was the winning trainer for owners of Louis Duco Stables, Inc. Criolla's Boy paid $13.40 to win. The 10th and final race of the week is a $12,500 claiming event. Three-year-olds and up, which have not won two races or three-year-olds, will be going a mile and a 16th on the turf course. Scratch the 4, the 6, the 15, and the 16.
And runners away. From the center, T-Minus gets the first call and will look for the early lead from Wildcat Kitten and None Tonight away second and third. Ben Jacob trying to cross over from his high post position. He races into that top vanguard about two behind. And it's a length and a half back to Whiskey Ding. And then to his outside, he is a gentleman as they sort themselves out into the first turn run. Southern Stroll saves ground, a length better than plausibly. And then it's a gap of another half length to the outside Trapnel Hall. Tritonian and Semferopol are next. It's a stretch of three lengths to Wise Maker. He's last of all. They bend into the backstretch with T-Minus in front of Ben Jacob, three parts of a length. Tucked in well, third is Wildcat Kitten. Then it's a length back to the outside. Racing on next is Trapnel Hall. Wider than him as he is a gentleman. Ben Jacob is toward the outside. He's now second. They went a quarter in 23 and 3. T-Minus is in front. He's been pressured every way. Every step of the way, Wildcat Kitten worked into the clear with Ben Jacob now three wide third. Then to the inside, and racing fourth is None Tonight. On hold as he is a gentleman. Toward the inside, Southern Stroll, covering ground on the outside. Trapnel Hall, Whiskey Ding between them. Stretch of two lengths to Plausibly. Then comes Semferopol and Tritonian. Trying to get underway from the back is Plausibly, and Wisemaker is trailed throughout. They're taking much closer order as T-Minus has called it an afternoon. Sweeping up on the outside, here's Trapnel Hall to take the lead from He Is a Gentleman, who's just to his inside. Wildcat Kitten cuts the corner with Ben Jacob, trying to find room inside. Here's a late run from None Tonight. 3/16 to go. Trapnel Hall with a big sweeping move to take over the lead. Running on from the back, Southern Stroll, and on the far outside, here's Semferopol down the center. Semferopol going best of all late, and he's 25-1. The Sunday hits keep coming, and Semferopol wins by 2 from Southern Stroll, then Trapnel Hall, Wildcat Kitten, and Whiskey Ding in 144-1.
Semferopol gets up to take the 10th race, giving Eddie Dominguez his second victory of the day. Douglas Saylor was the winning trainer for owner Patty Burns. Semferopol paid $52.40 to win another big price on today's card. So here's how our exotic wagers today. There was a consolation payout in the pick four. 3 of 4 paid $874.85. In the pick five, no one picked 5 of 5 winners. 4 of 5 returned $808.45. There will be a $36,226.74 carryover heading into Thursday's card. In the Rainbow Six, no one picked 6 of 6 winners. 5 of 6 returned $22,754.54. There will be a carryover in the Rainbow Six as well for Thursday. That stands at $109,932.62. And the carryovers continue in the Super High Five. The carryover for Thursday in that will be $17,741.30.
That's going to do it for Sunday's card and for our race week here at Gulfstream. We are on a 3-day break before we return to live racing on Thursday with a 1 o'clock p.m. post. We've got 9 races on the schedule, and we've got another 2-year-old race in the 6th race. 2-year-olds will be going 4.5 furlongs on the main track in a maiden claiming event with a $50,000 price tag. Trainer Wesley Ward is going to send out revolver sessions in this race. This is a daughter of the young sire Iqbal, and trainer Wesley Ward, he trained Iqbal during his race career, and he also trained the young sire's first winner when Happy as a Queen won here last week in a maiden claiming event. So, will there be deja vu on Thursday? You'll have to be here to find out. And, of course, we will have 8 other great races as well. I'll see you back here in a couple days. Get your handicapping hats on while we're away. Thanks for watching Thoroughbred Action at Gulfstream Park. I'm Katie Stazak.